Hello everyone. We will cover all important current affair news of 14th and 15th November. So let's begin. Our first news is Indra 2018. It is a India and Russia joint military exercise which is held in Jhansi, Uttar Pradesh. The joint military exercise between India and Russia, that is exercise Indra 2018, was conducted at Babina Field, firing ranges, Babina Military Station, Jhansi, Uttar Pradesh. It was 10th exercise in the series of exercise Indra, named at increasing interoperability India and Russian armies. So the exercise which is that is held between India and Russia, that name is Indra 2018, and it is a 10th exercise. So the next one is government launches LEAP and ARPIT programs of higher education faculty. So let's know about the LEAP and ARPIT. What is LEAP and what is ARPIT? Union Ministry of Human Resources Development launches two new initiatives with Leadership of Academicians Program, that is LEAP LEAP, and Annual Refresher Program in Teaching, that is ARPIT, for higher education faculty. ARPIT is a unique initiative of online professional development of 15 lakh higher education faculty. LEAP is a 3-week flagship leadership development training program for second level academic functionaries in higher education institutions. So next one is government to release rupees 57 commemorate coin to mark 75th anniversary of Tricolour hoisting by Subhash Chandra Bose. Union Ministry of Finance has announced to release 75 commemorative coin on occasion of 75th anniversary of hoisting of Tricolour for the first time by Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose at Cellular Jail, that is in Port Blair. Port Blair is the capital of Andaman Nicobar, on December 30, 1943. Earlier on October 21, 2018, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has hoisted a national flag at Red Fort and unveiled a plaque to commemorate 75th anniversary of formation of Azad Hind Government founded by Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. So let's talk about the features of this coin. It is a 35 gram coin which will composed of 50% silver, 40% copper, 5% nickel and 5% zinc. It will bear the postage of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose saluting flag on background of Cellular Jail. It will have numeral 75th along with the inscription anniversary, which will be depicted below port script. So it's a so in this news we have read rupees 75 commemorative coin to mark 75th anniversary of Tricolour hoisting by Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Next one is, let's talk about the first flag hoisting by Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Subhash Chandra Bose on December 30, 1943 has hoisted Tricolour for the first time on free Indian soil at Cellular Jail of Port Blair during the visit of Andaman and declaring the island as free territory from British rule. It was much before India attained independence in 1947. On same occasion, he had announced freedom of Andaman and Nicobar Island, making first Indian territory from the British rule, and renamed them as Shaheed Deep, that is Martyr Island, and Swaraj Deep, and its name is Self-Rule Island. The island at that time was liberated from British rule by Japan, which captured it during World War II. Major General Arkot Doraiswamy Loganathan of Indian National Army, INA, was made the governor of the Andaman and Nicobar Island. Next news is Infosys Prize 2018. Six professor awarded for science and research. So this is the list of six professors. The Infosys Science Foundation ISF occasion of its 10th anniversary announced six winners of Infosys Prize 2018 in the six different categories of award. They were selected from 244 nominations by 6 members of jury, renowned scientists and professors. So this is the list. Navakant Bhatt, he won that prize in engineering and computer science field. Next is Kavita Singh, he get this award in the field of humanities. Roop Malik get this award in life sciences. Nalini Ananthraman get this award in mathematical sciences. S.K. Sathis get this award in physical sciences, and Sendhil Mullainathan get this award in social sciences. So this is the list of awardee. So let's talk about the Infosys Prize. What is the prize money? What is the and many things we will discuss. Infosys Prize is an annual award bestowed upon researchers, scientists and social scientists and engineers in India by the Infosys Science Foundation, ISF. It is given to 6 categories. First one is life sciences, mathematical sciences, third is engineering and computer sciences, fourth is social sciences, fifth is physical sciences and sixth is humanities. The award intends to celebrate success in research and stand as a marker of excellence in this field. Each category awarded receives 22 karat gold medal, a citation certificate and prize money of $1 lakh. It is one of the highest monetary award in India that recognized in scientific research. A question can be asked that what is the highest monetary award in India that recognized the scientific research? So your answer will be Infosys Prize. Next one is World Diabetes Day. That is observed on 14th November every year. World Diabetes Day observed every year on across the world on 14th November to raise awareness about diabetes. Observance of the day aims to pursue multilateral efforts to promote and improve human health and provides access to them health care treatment and education. The theme of the World Diabetes Day 2018 and 19 is the family and the diabetes. The 2-year theme time frame has been chosen to raise awareness of the impact that diabetes has on the family and support network of those affected and promote role of family in management, care, prevention and education of diabetes. So let's move to our next news. Next one is 38th India and International Trade Fair held in Pragati Maidan, which is in New Delhi. The 38th India and International Trade Fair IITF was held in Pragati Maidan in New Delhi. The 14th day annual event was inaugurated by Union Minister of State of Culture, whose name is Mahesh Sharma. It is organized by India Trade Promotion Organization, ITPO. So let's talk about the ITPO. What is ITPO? It is a nodal agency of the Government of India under aegis of Ministry of Commerce and Industry of Promoting Countries External Trade. It is Mini Ratna Category 1 Central Public Sector Enterprises with 100% shareholding of the government, and its headquarters is in Pragati Maidan. Next is UP Cabinet approves renaming of Faizabad as Ayodhya and Allahabad as Prayagraj. So Uttar Pradesh government has approved renaming of Faizabad and Allahabad division as Ayodhya and Prayagraj respectively. The decision was taken at a meeting of state cabinet presided over by the Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath in state capital Lucknow. Now the proposal will go to central before the city is officially renamed. So let's talk about the background of Allahabad and Faizabad. Government has justified the name changes across Uttar Pradesh, saying that they are merely restoring older names and correcting historical distortions. Allahabad ancient name was Prayagraj, Prayag, but was changed after 16th century Mughal Emperor Akbar built fort near Sangam, the holy confluence of three rivers, Ganga, Yamuna, Saraswati. Akbar named the fort and its neighborhood Allahabad. Later, Akbar's grandson Shah Jahan renamed the entire city as Allahabad. But the area near the Sangam, the site of Kumbh Mela, continues to be known as Prayag. The reason cited for renaming Faizabad is that Ayodhya was the capital of Ikshvaku dynasty, to which the Hindu god Ram belonged, and that is the popular known as his birthplace. So that is the reason for changing the name of Allahabad. Next is PM inaugurates country's first multi-modal terminated constructed on river Ganga, that is in Varanasi. Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated India's first inland multi-modal terminal port on river Ganga at Ramnagar in Varanasi and receives the first container cargo belonging to PepsiCo. It is the first 4 multi-modal terminals being constructed on national waterways on River Ganga as a part of World Bank aided Jal Marg Vikas project of Inland Waterways Authority of India. The other 3 terminals are under construction at Sahibganj, Haldia, Ghazipur.